हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर नीलेश कुमार गुप्ता। आई एम वर्किंग एज अ प्रोफेसर एट अजय कुमार गर्ग इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गाजियाबाद। आई एम वर्किंग इन ईसीई डिपार्टमेंट। सो आई एम टीचिंग यू डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग। इट्स AKTU कोड इज KEC503 एंड आई एम गिविंग टूडे लेक्चर नंबर 34 एंड इट्स टाइटल इज एडाप्टिव फिल्टर। Last time also I discussed about the adaptive filter, because filters are electronic frequency selective network. But nowadays our conditions are changing rapidly. Okay, these are not fixed condition. Okay, and these are adaptive and time varying condition. So under the time varying condition, we have to employ such type of filter that should be adapt the our conditions. As per our condition, they will work. That type of filters we require nowadays. And generally, everywhere we use the adaptive filter, or we needed the use of adaptive filter in signal processing. That's why the role of adaptive filter in signal processing and communication is very important nowadays, because it would work as per the our present time varying condition, and it would be adaptive as per the conditions. Okay, and that's our requirement. Otherwise our system, our processing would not be successful for us, and we will not do any applications to the want extent, or we don't achieve our optimal condition. Because optimal condition is very very important, so we should learn this one. So adaptive filter. So what is the meaning of adaptive filter? An adaptive filter, okay, is used to find and track the optimum filter quickly and accurately. So generally in technology, we should try for getting the optimum value. Similarly, we have to try to design optimum filter. So that task we should complete with the use of adaptive filter. So what I am writing here, it is used to find and track the optimum filter quickly and accurately. Okay. So you have to find optimum filter in your processing task. Its performance is calculated using the concept of stability. Just we want the stability everywhere, quality, speed of adoption. It means if the conditions are changing so rapidly, so that as per the changing condition we have to adapt the condition. Okay, it means our speed, okay, of adoption or adapting the conditions, and tracking capability. So this is a short brief definition, you can say, of adaptive filter that we want to achieve nowadays. Okay, find and track the optimum filter quickly and accurately. Okay, now these are the applications like system identification, okay, speech and image encoding, channel equalization, noise cancelling, line enhancing, frequency tracking, interference reduction, acoustic echo cancellation. So these are the some applications part of our adaptive filter. So these are the number of applications that we needed now in our technology, especially in the field of signal processing. And these all will be possible with the help of adaptive filter. So now some algorithms you can use in under the adaptive filter, like LMS, RMS, okay, SDA and so on. Like at first we will talk about the LMS, that is least mean square algorithm. This is the most popular algorithm, that is LMS, developed by the Widrow and Hoff, follows the stochastic gradient algorithms and possess less computational complexity. So generally we should try that our complexity in computation should be less. Okay. So that is the advantage, you can say, using the LMS algorithm. Now steps for this algorithm, like computation of the output of an FIR filter produced by a set of filter coefficients. So first point is what you have to compute, can compute the output of FIR filter produced by a set of filter coefficient. Second one, you can say the generation of an estimated error by comparing the output of the filter to the desired response. So generation of your estimated error, how you will get the estimated error? In the last class also I told you, by comparing the your output of the filter, actual filter, and your to the desired response. You have to compare these two responses and then you can calculate and generate your estimated error. Now adjustment of the filter coefficients based on the estimated error, because this estimated error is very, very important, because if we want desired response, that is, that would be x. So our error should be minimum, or it will be zero ideally, then we achieve that condition and we will achieve our output that we needed here. Okay. So it depends upon our estimated error. Now LMS algorithm does not require the autocorrelation matrix of the filter input and cross correlation between the filter input and its desired signal. Okay. So LMS algorithm, this is the point you can understand here, it does not require the autocorrelation here and cross correlation between the filter input and its desired signal. It does not use expectation operation that is present in the steepest descent method. This is another type of algorithm that also you can use under the adaptive filter. Now implementation of the algorithm, okay, is a simple. The implementation of this algorithm is very, very simple. It does not require any matrix inversion type of calculation. It includes a step size parameter mu, which controls the stability and convergence of the algorithm. This is a very, very important point. What? Stability and convergence. Because our convergence and stability, these are the two very, very important parameters of the filter, and that should be controlled, okay, and that would be controlled by the step size parameter like mu. Here I am writing mu. Now it is a stable and robust algorithm, okay. This is another point, and then these are the properties of our LMS algorithm under the adaptive filter. Next we come on RLS. This is recursive least square algorithm. This is another type of algorithm. That algorithm we can use in adaptive filter, okay, for the several applications. But why we use RLS? Because lastly I told you about the what? Our LMS, okay. But some limitations of LMS are there. So to overcome those limitations, we come on RLS algorithm. A limitation of the LMS algorithm is that it does not use all the information contained in the input data set for the convergence. To overcome the problem of slow convergence of the LMS algorithm, RLS algorithm is implemented. So why it is implemented, why it is needed? Because to overcome the problem of slow convergence, the slow convergence in LMS algorithm. So to overcome this slow convergence in LMS algorithm, we use further what? RLS algorithm. The RLS algorithm uses the Newton's adaptation method to minimize the mean square surface, so it computes recursively. Now this algorithm uses a matrix inversion lemma
technique.
Since in case of LMS it does not require, it does not need it for us, okay. But in this matrix inversion lemma technique, you can use this algorithm. Generally uses this type of calculation, and it is a recursive implementation to minimize the LS objective function. So this is about the recursive least square algorithm. What is this? Why we are needed this type of algorithm? What are the limitation of LMS? That's why we are coming on RLS algorithm. Now comparison between the RLS and LMS. But some limitation of RLS also will be there. Like the main drawback of RLS algorithm is its computational complexity. The computational complexity is not present in LMS, but in RLS the computational complexity is there. Why? Because RLS algorithm uses the matrix inversion type of lemma techniques, and some computation calculations are more in RLS, since in case of LMS it was not there. So you can say this is the limitation of our RLS algorithm. But in general, RLS algorithm is preferred over the LMS algorithm, because the slow convergence problem that is in LMS, that can be overcome in RLS algorithm. So generally what our we are using the RLS algorithm over the LMS. The convergence rate of the LMS algorithm is governed by the choice of the step size, that is mu. What in the last PPTs I told you, by the use of this step size parameter mu, you can control the convergence rate and stability of the LMS algorithm, where this mu increasing the convergence. If this mu increases, then our convergence also increases. Okay, the convergence rate of RLS algorithm it is independent of the spread of eigenvalues within the input correlation matrix. So this these are the comparison between the RLS and LMS algorithm. Now again, RLS algorithm incorporates a forgating factor lambda, governs the rate of convergence and steady state error. This is in control system you learn about this ESS, this is steady state error. In a stationary environment, the best steady state performance results from slow adaptation, where our lambda is close to 1. Conversely, a smaller value of lambda, the result in faster convergence but greater steady state error. So if the greater steady state error, so our system will not be stable. So conversely, this may happen, okay. So remember this condition also in your mind. Now selection of adaptive algorithm, how you choose the adaptive algorithm, which adaptive algorithm you have to select for your particular application using the adaptive filter, okay. So these are the some parameters you can say. By selecting these parameters, okay, you can select our adaptive algorithm, like rate of convergence, okay. It may rate of convergence is what? The rate, the ऐसे rate जिसके ऊपर जिस rate पे हम optimum value को achieve कर सकते हैं. The rate of convergence is this one, the rate, this type of rate, okay. क्योंकि हमारा मकसद क्या है? What is our motto? Our objective is to achieve optimum value. Optimum value means to get the best possible results, okay. Now steady state error, now ability to track statistical variations in the input data, computational complexity, ability to operate with ill-conditional input data, sensitivity to variations in the input. So these are the some parameters. So keep in your mind these parameters, you can select adaptive algorithm in the your applications of the signal processing using the adaptive filter. Now, what is the linear prediction? So, linear prediction generally is of you can divide into two categories. First will be in forward linear prediction, you can say, and second you can say backward linear prediction. So, linear prediction means what? The linear prediction is an important tool in the field of signal processing. It is the process where we attempt to predict the value of the next sample, okay. You can predict the value of next sample given a set of previous samples, okay. So, what is linear prediction? It is an important tool in the field of our signal processing, or you can say it is a process where we attempt to predict the value of next sample given a set of, it means the based upon the previous samples that you have. Okay, the number of previous samples, okay, that you know required depends on the type of predictor that we employ. In communication generally the predictors we know, and I hope you studied, so predict that are the predictors, okay, that predictors I am talking here, okay. So the concept is same here also. So it depends upon the type of predictor. Which type of predictor you are using here? A predictor is said to have an order of small m if it has at most m taps in the forward or backward direction. The forward direction feed the forward elements are the zeros of the filter. So, forward direction the feed forward elements are the zeros of the filter. And in the backward direction, the feedback elements will be the poles of the filter. You know, because in any filter, okay, so if in any filter, mathematically, if you say what if h of z you have, so some numerator part and some denominator part, you know. So numerator part solution always shows the zeros, and denominator part shows the poles. So, similarly here, what your forward direction feed elements generally zeros of the filter. Ye zeros of the filter hote hain forward wale. Okay. Now, in backward direction, the elements will be the poles of the filter. So, backward mein, these will be the for backward. Okay. So, in this way, you can categorize your forward feed elements, you can say, and backward feed elements. Backward means the some feedback always will be there, okay, some memory, some so previous input, so these are required. So this is about the linear prediction, okay, that you should remember here. Now lattice filters, what is the meaning of lattice filters? So in FIR IIR also I told you about the lattice filters, and you can determine the designing and realization of lattice filters. So these are the lattice filters. So adaptive filters also are categorized into the lattice filters, that type of structure lattice, but some filter coefficients you have to determine here, that I am writing here. The lattice filters are interesting tool to use because they can simultaneously calculate the forward and backward filter coefficients. So, simultaneously they can calculate the forward and backward filter coefficients given a set of spatial reflection coefficients. So, what I am telling you, what, okay, what I am representing here, so you have to calculate simultaneously forward and backward filter coefficients. Okay, given a set of special reflection coefficients. So this is the new points, okay, reflection coefficients. Forward and backward filter coefficient, you know here what? By the zeros and poles, you can determine, you can analyze forward and backward filter coefficients. Okay, and you these will be determined with the reference of reflection coefficient. These reflection coefficients, okay, can be calculated from the forward or backward filter coefficient. That's I am writing here. The same sentence here it is repeating. Okay, so you can calculate our reflection coefficient from the forward or backward filter coefficient. Also, the reflection coefficients, okay, can be calculated from other matrix. You can calculate reflection coefficient from the forward and backward filter coefficient, and also you can calculate these reflection coefficient from the other matrices like our signal power and autocorrelation function. In communication, generally you, if you study properly signal system and DSP, so signal power and autocorrelation function, these are the very very important parameter and titles, you can say functions, okay, in pe kafi kuch depend karta hai. So you can also determine reflection coefficients from the signal power and autocorrelation functions also. Firstly, you can determine our reflection coefficient from the forward or backward filter coefficient. Secondly, you can also determine these coefficient, these reflection coefficient from the signal power and autocorrelation function. Now, some applications that also I tell you of the adaptive filter. So, first is system identification. What is the meaning of this? So, here you are giving the input signal x of n from here, and this is our adaptive filter, and this is our unknown system. Unknown system, our signal process to the unknown system, and it will give to some output here d of n, and the output of adaptive filter is this one. This is d of n also, so d cap, this one d cap n. And this is our adder, this adder add these two signal dn and dcon, and the difference of this dn and d cap n is called e of n. E of n means your estimated error. This is called your estimated error between the your filter signal and your desired signal. So this error, and this also shows the MSE. This is mean square error. In signal processing and in communication, two parameters are very very important. First is our signal to noise ratio. Generally, whenever you do the some research in signal processing, so these two parameters you generally you calculate. What first is signal to noise ratio? This would be better, be maximum. Okay, practically it should not be zero. And second is our MSE, minimum square error. It should be minimum. So this estimated error generally shows the MSE, minimum square error. So what adaptive filter generally try to achieve, the difference e of n is equal to 0, it should be 0. So adaptive filter ka work hi hai ki in dono ke beech ka difference kam se kam ho aur it should be 0, then we achieve the our optimum value. हम चाहते हैं आउटपुट हमारा x हो, तो x ही होगा. कैसे होगा? वी आर अप्लाइंग सम एल्गोरिथम अंडर द एडाप्टिव फिल्टर प्रोसेसिंग एंड आवर फिल्टर आउटपुट एंड डिजायर्ड आउटपुट मस्ट बी इक्वल इन ईच अदर एंड द कंपैरिजन ऑफ द सिग्नल बिटवीन दीज टू विल बी जीरो और e ऑफ n इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो दिस इज अवर सिस्टम आइडेंटिफिकेशन. यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई यूर सिस्टम adapting this some algorithms under the adaptive filter processing, and you can identify your system. So this is the one of the application of adaptive filter. You can identify the system easily here. Now second one is what? This one. And I'm writing here these contents for this application. This application is what? This application is adaptive noise cancellation. So adaptive noise cancellation. Noise is very very important. Generally noise is coming in signal. Whenever you communicate any signal, so noise will be there. So adaptive noise cancellation means if in the channel noise is coming, noise will come, definitely it will come. So by using the some adaptive algorithm under the adaptive filter processing, we have to cancel the noise, adaptive noise, that is time varying, that is not stable, that is not, it means it is changing in dynamic condition. So at that time you have to apply you needed adaptive noise cancellation. So this type of application is very very important here. Here what? X of n plus v1n, it is coming the signal, and this is the noise, okay, adaptive noise you can say, and this is v2n, it will go to the adaptive filter and it will proceed here, okay, and this is the adder, this signal is coming here, or e of n is equal to what? This signal is xn plus v1n and this is d cap n, the difference between, this is again estimated error, that again further shows the calculation of MSE, minimum square. So this is the error between these two signal, first signal is this, second signal is this, okay, this one, the difference between these two signals. Now what I am writing here, the reference signal recorded by a primary microphone, the device, and we are taking here microphone, any other device you can also take, consists of a desired signal x of n, which is corrupted by an adaptive noise v1n, because signal is there, so noise definitely will be there. So we assume here a microphone consisting of a signal of x of n that is corrupted by an additive noise of v1n in your channel. Now input signal of the adaptive filter is a noise signal, that is v2n, recorded by a secondary microphone that is correlated with the interference signal v1n but uncorrelated with xn. So obviously it will be correlated with this and uncorrelated with another signal. So in this way we have to try here what, that noise would be cancelled out, that's why it is called adaptive noise cancellation under the adaptive condition in the adaptive filter processing. So some real world examples of noise cancellation with adaptive filters are acoustic echo cancellation in the hearing aids, you can you understand this one, noise cancellation in hydrophones, power line interference cancellation in electrocardiography and so on. So this type of adaptive noise cancellation circuit you can use in several places, like these examples that I am giving in this PPT. And there are so many applications of adaptive filters here, like enhancing, okay, in medical field and some another type of application. There are so many applications that are available of adaptive filter in signal processing field. You can use those applications and easily achieve your optimum values. So this was about the adaptive filter. I hope it is clear to everybody what is the meaning of adaptive filter, what are the properties of adaptive filter, what are the generally algorithms available in adaptive filter using in signal processing. Now choice of adaptive algorithm, choice of factors, some factors are there, on the basis of those factors you can चूज द एडाप्टिव फिल्टर एल्गोरिथम लाइक LMS, RLS एंड सो ऑन. देन सम लीनियर प्रोडक्शन लेटेस्ट फिल्टर सम टूल्स आई टोल्ड यू इन शॉर्ट हेयर. ओके देन एप्लीकेशंस जनरली यू ऑल आर द इंजीनियर्स सो ऑलवेज यू शुड नो द एप्लीकेशन पार्ट ऑफ द दिस एडाप्टिव फिल्टर. सो एडाप्टिव फिल्टर्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टाइटल वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट वी आर यूजिंग इन सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग फील्ड. And these are my references. You can refer these books for the contents of this lecture. Thank you very much. Goodbye.